University of Guam and the field house and the World Cadet Challenge and the final stages of this event, now coming down to the business end of things. And I'm here with Michael Brown, the team manager for Oceania, but also the development officer hired by the ITF for Oceania. And I mean, is there a sigh of relief now when this is over? But I mean, it's been fantastic, really, on a level that I didn't expect.
Yeah, the whole event's been great. We've been working towards this for many years to have an event held in Oceania and also to have our Oceania team. It's a big process for us. Back in April this year, we had our qualification event, then going through all the paperwork and administrative work to get everybody here and also trying to assist Guam where possible with the preparation for the event as well. So it's been almost looking after two teams to some extent, but it's good that we're at the final day now.
And I know that you physically spent time here before trying to work with the Guam Association and trying to help and support them. And if you assess that, is there anything you would have done different, or are you happy with how, of course, they presented this event very well?
Yeah, the presentation of the event's amazing. Back when I made a visit back in July, it was during the school holidays of the summer break, and a lot of the players had summer work or had gone on holidays to Korea or Japan, so maybe the timing might have been a bit better during a school period where we could have had training sessions for the kids after school. But apart from that, everything else in that trip went well, and like we said, the presentation here has been amazing and the event's been memorable for everybody.
If you can explain also the ITF development work now, of course, is to leave a legacy here and try to get table tennis going, try to introduce table tennis in schools and all levels. How would you do that?
Yeah, so fortunately we have the Guam Table Tennis Federation's very active at the moment with their own development program, with implementation of table tennis through villages and also schools as well. So now it's a matter of laying the grassroots level at the moment, and now it's trying to build the structures to allow the players to progress further. And so that's what we'll be planning in the next couple of years during our visits, to get more coaches, more umpires, more structures that allow a pathway for the junior players.
So the Guam Association now knows what really what world class level on cadet level is, and you and I know it as well. A lot of people may not, because let's say the top players here are extremely good, and of course there's still after many years running this competition, naturally a gap between the best and the little bit lesser good. But how would you see that gap, and how do you see it from an Oceania perspective?
Yeah, I think the biggest issue for us with the gap is table tennis throughout the Oceania region is not seen as a professional sport. So for a lot of people, it's difficult just to get involved in the sport with smaller population base, and then trying to get people into a professional setting, where for Guam, this has been a great opportunity to see table tennis at the highest level. And hopefully from this, it'll leave a legacy in people realising that it is a professional sport and not just a social event that people can play at home or in caravan parks around the world. So,
and your own players performing here, and I know you have some young players here that, you know, hopefully can kickstart a little bit of more hard work when they come back home. Do you think it works from a goal setting point of view to have the Cadet Challenge, and that young players in the Oceania region is aware of this somehow?
Yeah, I think the Global Cadet Challenge is one of the stepping stones for most of our national associations. It's one of the events that all 24 of our member associations have a good chance of qualifying a player for. And so now we've got to continue to build on that from not just the Cadet Challenge, but now focus on World Junior Championships, Olympic Games, and the bigger pictures as well, not just realise that the Cadet Challenge is the last event available for the people. And now it's just a matter of getting those structures in place to build further upon the Cadet Challenge into the junior ranks and also the senior open tournaments as well.
Plenty of challenges ahead for Michael Brown in Oceania, and plenty of challenges for many players obviously here to develop to the next 2013 Cadet Challenge. Thank you very much.
Thank you.